Hello and welcome to the channel. In this video I'll be doing a compression test on Barney, my 1981 Honda CT110 Trail. And if you're using a cheap compression tester, much like this one that I've got here, I'll be showing you why it can give you a false reading, it'll read too low, and what I've done to make the gauge read more accurately. Now let's get straight into it. So what I'll do, we'll carry out a compression test using the flexible hose and the adapter and also the steel tube as supplied by the kit. Then we'll move on to a homemade adapter that I've made and we'll compare the different results. Well, using the flexible hose as supplied by the kit and the adapter, I've connected the gauge on there. I've got the throttle wide open. I've made sure that the choke's not on. Let's kick the engine over and check the reading. It's not going any higher than that, but the gauge is reading 90 psi, and as you saw as I was kicking it, the needle would flicker and that would indicate the air's escaping back into the cylinder. But as you noticed on this gauge, it only registered 90 psi and the gauge flickered up and down. What happens with this gauge, with this kit, especially on a small engine, the end of the hose there's a very small valve, but what you can do, you can blow gently through that and air can pass back the other way. So it's not a good valve, it's a bore valve I think. You're much better off to have a Schrader valve. So what can you do to improve the accuracy of this test kit? Well, if you use this steel tube onto the gauge and then press this against the spark plug hole, I found that that gives a much more accurate result. And I think the reason for that is, firstly, there's not as much volume in there, but as you can see, this tube has a Schrader valve in there, where this flexible hose has a valve, but it's a bore valve, a bore check valve, it's not a Schrader valve, and so it doesn't seal off as quickly. So I found using this is accurate, but you can also have air escaping from there. Plus it needs two people. You need one person to hold this against the engine and another person to kick, kick, kick on the kickstart. So what I did, I took the other steel tube, I got a spark plug, cut out the inside, fitted the steel tube, put a Schrader valve in the end there, so that what I can now do is connect this gauge to there. This will screw into the engine and let's see what the difference is. Let's see if I'm right. And so now we've got the steel tube with the rubber tip that's simply pressed against the spark plug hole, and this is more difficult because really you need two people. You need one person to hold this and a second to press the kickstarter. I'm going to try and do it by hand, see what happens. It was a little bit of a struggle on my own, but I was able to hold the adapter in place, press the kickstarter, and I've managed to get the PSI now up to 110, which is better than 90, but you could hear air escaping, so still not perfect. Let's screw in my homemade adapter and see what results that gives. Let's kick the bike over and see if there's any difference. Remember, thought, was it 90 psi before? As we can see, much more accurate result. And as you saw, the gauge went up really quickly. The needle didn't flicker, so there was no air escaping back into the cylinder. And it's recorded 140 psi, which, although not perfect, it's on the bottom end of what's acceptable. But it's a lot better than 90 psi. So if you have one of these cheap compression testers, watch out for that. Don't let the long flexible hose trick you into stripping down your engine for no reason. If you get some value from these videos, if you find them useful, consider subscribing, it's free, help the channel along, and also you won't miss out on any upcoming content that you may be interested in. And I'll see you again soon in the next video.